Hi, I'm finally back with another Cubyz devlog. It's been 6 months already and a lot has happened. In April, a friend of mine, Til++, decided to join Cubyz. One of the first things we tried to implement together was multiplayer. But quite soon we found a big problem. The engine wasn't designed with multiplayer in mind, and some parts of the code are quite hostile towards a change like this. So instead of using the old engine, we thought, hey, let's rewrite everything from scratch. It can't be that hard, right? And just like that, we got working. After setting up OpenGL and making a window, we started working on the GUI system. Because we wanted to implement it properly, we took our time, and before we even got finished, I already had another plan. I thought, hey, we are already rewriting Cubyz, so why not use a different programming language or a different graphics API? And just like that, we decided to switch to C++ and Vulkan. And it turns out that was already our second mistake. Setting up C++ with Vulkan is harder than anticipated. But we didn't give up that fast. After a couple of days, we finally managed to get it working on our systems, and we decided to leave the rest for the future. With that out of the way, we can finally get started, right? Well, there's still one thing missing. Vulkan. And it turns out, Vulkan is a lot harder to work with than OpenGL. You have to set a lot of parameters with caution, and you also have to take care of many things that OpenGL just handles in the background. After a few weeks of trying to understand Vulkan, I decided that it's enough. After all, I want to make a game and not try to understand a graphics API. I also had some issues with C++. C++ makes it really hard for me to support multiple platforms. But I really want to support Windows, so I guess my only option is to return to Java. Luckily, we still had the Java rewrite project, and I started working on it again. One thing I immediately noticed, though, was that the code looked really ugly and wasn't very well commented. So I did my third mistake. I ignored all those warning signs and I started refactoring the code. After I finished refactoring, Til++ told me that I went against his plans, and that is also why he left later. So this made my mistake even worse. Even after that, I still didn't give up. I continued with terrain rendering. I wanted the rendering to be less buggy than in the old version, and because of that, I thought through many possibilities. I didn't find a good solution, so I was stuck in this analysis paralysis, and I didn't get anything done. After quite some time, I finally decided to do something rather than nothing, and the outcome of that wasn't really that good. With rendering done, I thought I could finally move on to the fun stuff. So I started working on some terrain generation again. I implemented a pretty good biome placement algorithm, but quite soon I found out there is still so much missing. I need an entity system, player movement, block breaking and placing, item drops, an inventory, and all that stuff. Stuff that the old version of Cubyz already had. So why do I need to implement it again? Why am I doing this? So why was I making the rewrite? I wanted to implement multiplayer. And I also wanted to have a cleaner code base and a more stable game. Has anything of that happened? Not really. I mean, sure, the codebase is now more friendly towards multiplayer, but it's gonna take a long time to get there. and it would be way faster to just take the old code and put multiplayer into it. And what about the code base? Is it cleaner now? No, not at all. I somehow managed to make less comments in the code than in the old version of Cubyz. And from a stability perspective, the game is really bad. I mean, just look at the terrain rendering. It's super buggy. Just like that, I ended the rewrite project. It was a big mistake and an even bigger waste of time. But it's not all lost. I learned something. And some parts of the code were actually better than the original project. For example, the biome generator I mentioned. With a bit of tweaking, I was able to fit it into the main project and take a look at it. And then there's also the text renderer. In the rewrite, we developed a text renderer that is capable of drawing pixel art fonts with full Unicode support. And additionally, it also allows for some rendering hints such as bold text, italic text, and all that stuff. These rendering hints can be activated using a Markdown-inspired syntax, which you can see here. After I ended the rewrite, I still took some time to implement some features before making this video. Here's a list of them. At first, I re-implemented infinite terrain, which required me to rewrite the climate map generation. Then I did some new textures for cactus, sand, and ice. Then I made the LOD chunks, which are the chunks that you can see in the distance, have their own texture instead of being just uniformly colored. Then I made a new ore generation system, which allows ores to appear more natural with some space between them, and all that is configurable in the data files. After that, I made a new menu background, which is basically just a 3D image of the world. And after that, I mostly did some tweaking, such as balancing and performance improvements. For example, Cubyz now uses much less memory. And of course I did some bug fixes, as usual. That's all for now, I hope you learned something, and I'll be back in a couple months. If you want to play the game, there's a link in the description. There's also a link to our Discord server, where you can receive more regular updates.